2012 with ONN's Jim Heath.
And Jim Heath joins us now with a closer look at what this means for Ohio. Jim, Nevada is a small state, but it still adds momentum for Romney, right?
Yeah, Denise, it's a huge win because it demonstrates officially now that Romney is the one remaining Republican candidate who can win nationally. He's won in the Northeast up in Massachusetts. He's won in the South in the big state of Florida. Now he's won out West. Romney has money in the bank, field operations in key upcoming states like Colorado, where he was earlier today. And if the conservative element within the Republican Party that doesn't like Romney, if they don't figure out a way to slow his momentum and soon, this contest will be over by March. Now, there's still time for Romney's opponents. To be the top Republican nominee, Denise, you need 1,144 delegates. You can see here, as of tonight, mixing in Nevada's 28 delegates, I estimate that Romney has around 105, as you see there. Gingrich, 31, Ron Paul, 15, and Rick Santorum, just 8. But Denise, winning means momentum, and Romney is going to keep winning just about everything in sight during this month of February.
So does Newt Gingrich make a stand here in Ohio on Super Tuesday?
I'll tell you what, he has to. Mm-hmm. I mean, there are several key southern primaries on Super Tuesday, March 6th, but everyone expects Newt Gingrich to win those primaries in the South. He's become a sort of a southern regional candidate who cannot win outside of that area. Now, if his campaign is going to continue, he has to make a stand right here in Ohio, prove that he can win outside of the South. If he doesn't, as it appears right now, Mitt Romney will be the nominee who takes on President Obama this fall.